Hello everyone, myself Dr. Aditya Gupta. So in this video, I wanted to talk to something which a lot of aspirants, NEPG aspirants struggle with, that is your grand test. So grand test shouldn't give you BT. I wanted to bust some myths about grand test that you should understand basically. The first myth I wanted to bust was that contrary to popular belief is that grand tests are not supposed to be a rank determining ki, oh, this is the rank that I'll actually get in the exam before grand test. No. The purpose of grand test is actually very, very different. The purpose of grand test is to understand time management. The purpose of a grand test is to get the feel of the exam. The purpose of the grand test is to understand ki, oh, 19 subjects, 3 hours, how am I going to solve? How am I going to go to the deepest recesses of my memory to finally understand ki kis question ko kaise attempt karna hai? That is the purpose of the grand test. Purpose of grand test is never rank. And because people keep on confusing the purpose of the grand test ki rank kya aati hai, kya honi chahiye, that is the reason grand test dete hain and they end up having a BT, they end up having a bad trip, that they end up thinking ki aur grand test nahi dunga, they keep on getting scared. If it is any consolation, meri grand test mein, I never got a rank which was below 500. All my ranks in grand test were in either in 700, 1000, more than 1000 or so on. Actual rank was 17. Why? Because I used grand test not for rank determination. I used grand test in order to know ki 3 ghante mein how I'm going to solve the paper. That is the main purpose of grand test. That is the purpose that's on the actual exam day, you're not anxious. Second thing, how many grand tests to give? So people should realize that every weekly grand test, if you're giving, so what you're doing is you're just giving grand test and reviewing grand test. That is the entire purpose of your life. No, that is not the entire purpose of your life. That is the entire purpose of your life, at least for the 6 months, is preparing for the exam, reviewing, understanding, revision. This is the purpose of the exam. So if you keep on giving weekly grand test, one day is given gone in giving grand test, 2 days are gone in reviewing grand test. So you are 50% of your time is just grand test. All you will remember is grand test. You won't be able to revise the syllabus in the first place. Don't do that. The sweet spot in my opinion is giving a grand test in once in 3 weeks. Another thing I want to emphasize particularly is that you should try to give grand test of different platform. Ek platform ka paid le lo, other platforms ke free GTs, her platform, some or the other form of free GTs karta hi hai. Give those free GTs of other platform. What happens because of that is you get to know ki a similar topic, an important topic, different form mein kaise poocha ja sakta hai. How can they ask the similar question in multiple formats? If you keep on giving grand test of just one platform, what will happen is you'll get accustomed to that particular questions on how that particular platform frames grand test. In this particular regard, I'll say on June 18, there's a free grand test. An Academy is conducting this free grand test and mega scholarship test. So if you're someone who was thinking, I want to buy an Academy subscription, I want to learn from Dr. Nikita, Dr. Preeti, I want to learn from Dr. Pritesh. This is your chance to get a really good scholarship also. This is your chance to get, ace your NEPG preparation. This is your chance to get personal mentorship from these people as well, from your top faculty. So do give this. Again, it's a free grant test. So in my opinion, koi bhi free grant test ho, any platform, definitely dena chahiye. I'll give the link in the description so that you can give this grant test for free. All right. So remember, most important, first thing, the purpose of grant test is not to get your BT. It's not to determine your rank. It's to understand ki how to manage time in those 3 hours. It's how to understand to get the feel of the exam. The third important thing, again, coming back to grand test shouldn't give BT. The purpose of the grand test is ki tumhari progress pata chalti rahe. So if you're getting a regular, progress tumhari hoti rahi hai grand test mein. 80 the, 90 ho gaye, 100 ho gaye, 120 ho gaye. Nothing to worry about, even if your ranks are slightly low in the beginning. But start giving grand test to get the feel of the exam. To know ki exam kya hota hai, MCQ kaise solve karte hain, dar mein kaise MCQ solve karte hain, anxiety mein kaise MCQ solve hota hai. That is the main purpose of the grand test. Don't look at ranks. Don't get in BT. Don't be scared ki, arey, ab main kya karunga? Ab how I will, exam diya, grand test diya, grand test mein mistake. So you are not getting the desired, sort of predicted rank. That should not result in you not studying. Grand test should not give BT. Last but definitely not the least, how to review a grand test and how to review ki how to understand ki agar grand test scores stagnant ho jaye, how to improve them. Purpose of grand test is, like I told you, time management and at the same point of time seeing the constant progress. Ab tumhara score stuck ho gaya, understand ki score stuck kyun hua hai. There are two types of mistakes. One is factual and one is, other type is conceptual. Factual mistakes go in your 20th notebook so that you can revise them again and again. Conceptual mistake, watch a video, YouTube video, jo bhi platform use kare uski video, get your concepts clear taki agli baar wo mistakes nahi. So this is the 4-step process of ensuring that the grant tests are done in a great way. Last thing, definitely not the least, give the free grant test of Unacademy if you want to. You will get a, you know, scholarship, some form of prize money and some way. And you obviously get the chance to interact with your top faculty. That's it from my side today. Thank you and have a nice day.